Well, as you know, the Mountie image, much like moose in mountains, is what a lot of people around the world know of Canada, if they know nothing else. And the Mountie image evokes a lot of Canadiana. It's about adventure. It's about the wild, wild west, the untamed wilderness. And it all sort of started, there was a constellation of factors that came together in the early part of the last century. When you all of a sudden had movies with sound and they were looking for images and excitement and adventure, and you also had adventure books that kids would read, the Mountie just became a very popular topic in movies and books, mainly fiction. And it just it became massive both in the United States, Great Britain, and also in Canada. But most of what you see here in this collection was generated, published in Great Britain and the United States. Al's collection is unparalleled. He has about 9,000 individual items which have been donated to the University of Alberta, and there is no other collector that I'm aware of in the world that has that many pieces of Mountie paper, books, magazines, comics. So his is the biggest.
The Mounted Police played a big part in Western history. I mean, they came to Calgary and Fort McLeod and Fort Edmonton. So this is the early history of the Mounted Police. I mean, this is where most of it started, was right here in Alberta. And there's not another institution in the world that collects Canadian history, Western, like the University of Alberta. It's fantastic. In 1963, I bought my first Mounted Police book. And it's about Colonel McLeod, because I'd studied him in the training. So I started browsing used bookstores and picking up different novels and RCMP books. And probably up until 1995, I acquired probably 3,000, 3,500 books. It really opened up in the late 90s, 95, 97. The American Book Exchange, known as ABE, and eBay came online and opened up the entire world to being able to sell different items. So what I did is I started to search those particular websites and also started to list things I was looking for. So I would say the collection was growing rapidly, probably 50, 60 items a week that I obtained off the internet. And so my collection just kept building and building until it reached about over 9,000 items, I guess, in 2008. They're displayed just so beautifully, and I haven't stopped smiling. I've been here for 4 hours now. It's just an incredible display. The exhibition is magnificent. They've put out a lot of beautiful items, and I'm very proud to be able to come back and see them again and to know they're safe and have a home.